So hi, in this video show how to use the Teach graphical user interface to develop robotic applications in simulation. So we start by adding the root directory, which is ART3.1.7. So click on Add to Path, and select the folders and subfolders. Inside this directory, so this is our current path, run init lib to initialize the library and start by loading a robot. We first will going to load the ABB-140 robot. And once this is done, type teach, and the teaching pendant appears. So by clicking on these buttons, we can easily load a different robot, load end tools, load auxiliary equipment or a piece. For example, we can load a different robot. For example, let's load a KUKA robot. So under the KUKA directory, the KIR16 arhole wrist is here. Click on the parameters.m file. And the robot appears here. You can move the robot with the teaching application using the joint movement or moving the end effector in lines or reorientation. That's it. Now load an end tool. For example, we may go to the robots directory, equipment, and end tools. And for example, we can load the spot welding tool. So we click on refresh and the tool is drawn at the end of the robot. And also we can, for example, if you click on load equipment, there are some environments that come with the library. For example, go to bodywork and load the bodywork environment, and with this you will be ready to click on refresh, and then you will be ready to develop a spot welding application in simulation with your robot. You have a look at the video called a manufacturing demo applications with ARTE, and then it will show you how to place target points and program trajectories with a robot. Just move and you have a complete setting to develop your application. Click on Reset All to reset all the join values. Click on Edit the edit this data, for example, change the height. So you may load a different robot by clicking on load robot at any time. The IRB52 is going to be loaded now. We should wait until every link is loaded. And use these controls here to move the robot to any position. For example, move to this position. And you have to be aware that not every orientation and position is visible. This says it says that one of the joints is out of the range, which corresponds to the joint 5. And if we have a look at the robot window, you see that that it's true. So load a different robot, load a different tool if you will. Go to robots, equipment, and tools, and for example vacuum 1, once the link is. So this is your end tool, which is a vacuum end tool, and refresh. And if you click on reset all, so if you wish, you can also load a robotic cell by clicking on load equipment. And for example, you may load the bumper cutting environment and click on refresh. Again, change the orientation by dragging the sliders and try to develop your application in simulation. Again, click on move to change, for example, the head of the end tool.